Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Labs. In this video, I'm going to explain you how you can set up a single node Hadoop cluster in Windows. One thing might come to your mind right now. Why Windows? First thing is, many of us use it as our primary OS. So using Hadoop around your comfortable environment can be a plus point. And the second is, well, I can't think of anything else for using Windows for Hadoop. But also on the other hand, setting up Hadoop framework manually or doing a custom installation can help you in many ways, you know. First and foremost, it is easy and very light to run in case you have limited usage of big data resources. Suppose you want to practice some commands in HDFS or run a small MapReduce job or any Spark job on YARN using Hadoop. So these are really very small requirements. For such small practice requirements, this turns out to be very easy and light to run. Second very important benefit can be, it can provide you a deep understanding of Hadoop library setup, all the important config files and their use, and other under the hood concepts of Hadoop framework. Also, this custom installation can provide you a vision of scaling the Hadoop cluster up or down as per your future requirement. So now, don't you think it is important to have a look on custom installation of Hadoop framework instead of using some pre-built Hadoop cluster? So let's try to build a Hadoop environment on our Windows 10 computer natively, where we spend most of our time, so that we can get going on practicing our big data stuff whenever we want without loading those huge pre-built virtual machines. So this is my Windows 10 computer. Currently I am using Windows 10 Professional. That doesn't matter actually. Windows 10 Home, Pro, everything will work the same way. It is just to let you know the configuration of my host machine. The processor is 8th generation i3, 2.10 GHz and 12 GB of memory. So very first thing, you need to validate that if you have Java installed on your machine, specifically JRE and JDK. So to validate that, open command prompt and type java-version. If you have the JRE installed, you will have this kind of output. Whatever version of JRE you have, you'll get the version here. I'm using Java 1.8. If you are getting an error here that Java command or keyword is not found, that means you do not have Java or JRE installed on your machine. So with java-version command, you can validate your JRE. And let's also validate the JDK by executing javac-version. So I have the JDK also installed. If you do not have that, you have two options. Either you can install Java from Oracle, that is by going to Oracle's website, Java 8 download. You can see the first link, Java SE Development Kit. From here you can install the Java SE Development Kit. This will include both your JRE and JDK. Obviously, if you have JDK, you need to have JRE. So just to simplify things, you can go to Java download page for Oracle and just download JDK latest version for Windows 64-bit. This will include everything, your JRE and JDK. So this was the simple step. Some of you might already have it. For just one further check on this, that probably some of you might not have configured, that is setting up Java home or adding the Java bin directory into your environment variables. Otherwise, the commands like javac or java might not work. So in case you have downloaded the JDK and you have installed using the installation wizard, after that automatically the installation wizards adds the JRE path to your environment variables. Let me show you that quickly. You can go to My Computers, right click, Properties, Advanced System Settings, Environment Variables. Here you can see the system, under the system variables path, go to Edit, and you can see this might already be done with your installation wizard of Java. That is, it will add the path of Java to your environment's path variable. Let us see what is here. I'll go to this path. You can see in this path we only have Java. In such cases, your java-version command will work, but javac will not work. So JDK is installed on your system, but still you need to add the JDK path. For doing that, you can go to Program Files directory. Inside this Java, here you can see after installation, you'll get the folder JDK. And inside that, bin. Here you can see you have the Java and javac all files. So this particular path you can copy and add to the same environment variables. You can see here, you can click on new. I have already added, and similarly you can add it here and press OK. After that, your Java C command will also start working and you can validate the version. We are done with Java installation. Now let's start with Hadoop installation. First thing for Hadoop installation is we should have Hadoop binaries, obviously. For that, you can search on Google, or I'll also provide you the link in the description. You can search with Hadoop download and go to the official website Hadoop Apache org releases, and you can download if you have any specific version in mind, otherwise the latest version, that is 3.1.3. Make sure you download the binary. Once you click on this, the tar file for Hadoop binaries will start getting downloaded. I have already downloaded it. Once you download it, you can place it somewhere as I have done, in C or D drive, whatever you like, inside any particular folder. This kind of tar file will be downloaded. Once you get it, extract it using WinZip, WinRAR or 7-Zip, any compression software that you have. I have already extracted it. So this is the kind of folder which you will get. The folder named as Hadoop hyphen the version. Inside that, again, you will get the same. You can open it. And inside that, this is the standard structure of a Hadoop binary. I have redundant folders. So what I will do, I'll copy everything outside. Fine, this is empty now. I'll remove it. Sorry. Now we have the Hadoop binary. So first thing, let us add this bin directory same way as we added for Java home. Let us add this same bin directory to our environment variables to access the binaries inside this directory. Okay, so let me copy the bin path. I'll go inside my environment variables, advanced system settings, environment variables, go to the path, edit, add new, and add the Hadoop bin path. Click on OK. Now second step is to set up the configuration files. Here is when the important stuff starts. Basically, we have four configuration files that we have to configure while installing Hadoop. Core site.xml, MapRed site.xml, HDFS site.xml, YARN site.xml, and one of the CMD file that we will use to start the Hadoop daemons. What and where we are going to do this, I'll show you here. All these config files you will find in etc folder. Inside this Hadoop, we have to take care and set up core site.xml, MapRed site.xml, HDFS site.xml, YARN site.xml, and this is our Hadoop env cmd file. Let me expand this too so that you can see the type Windows command script. So all the configurations will be picked up from core site, HDFS site, MapRed and YARN site, and using those configurations we will start our Hadoop cluster with the help of Hadoop env cmd file. Hope you get it. So let's see what changes we have to make. Let's go one by one. Let's open core site.xml, and here under configuration tags, you have to add the property of a default file system, that is under core site.xml. So these are the tags for the property. I'll mention this tag in the description if you want. Core site.xml has to tell us what will be our default file system. We want to access it on localhost 9000 port. This was the only change in core site.xml as far as single node Hadoop cluster is concerned. Let's save it and close it. Next comes MapRed site.xml. Let's open it the same way. And inside this file's configuration tab, we have to mention the property of MapReduce framework. So here you have to mention MapReduce.framework.name should be YARN. This is the only change for MapRed site.xml. Let's close it. Next comes YARN site.xml. Let's open this the same way. Inside this configuration tabs, you have to mention a couple of properties. Let me align them. These properties are important for YARN to work. As you know, YARN is a resource manager. So what parameters and what variables are to be considered by YARN in shuffling the resources? You can say what buffer size it has to take, what other properties it has to take. For that, we need to provide proper class name inside YARN site.xml that it is going to use. You can take these properties from the description below. Let's save it and close it. Now let us come to HDFS site.xml. Here we have to provide the property something like this. Let me align this. This HDFS site.xml will have one property that is a replication factor. By default it is 3, but we have a single node cluster. We don't need such replication. I'll mention it as 1. Then we have to provide the directory that will be going to be used by name node. Name node name directory. We have to mention the name node directory. But as of now, we don't have any name node directory, right? So let's create it somewhere. Let us go into Hadoop main directory only and create a directory as data. Inside this, let's create one directory as name node and one directory as data node. And let's copy this path to data node and paste it in data node value. Similar way, the name node directory to be copied in name node value. Now that's it. Now we are done with the setup of all important config files. Now we need to see how this Hadoop env is going to trigger our Hadoop environment. Let's see what this script has. So it has all the values that it is going to pick up from Windows environment, because it has to run Hadoop on Windows environment. So guys, closely note here, you will see Java home mentioned as percent Java home percent. So this in Windows environment means Java home that this Hadoop startup script is going to use will be the Java home that is defined in environment variables. Okay. So let's see, is there any Java home in our environment variables? I don't see any Java home defined. One workaround for this is you can mention a Java home here. Or another thing, whatever path we have for Java, that is this particular thing, you can directly mention in your Java home. Make sure you don't include bin here. Same case is for Hadoop home. I'll tell you the other way around also. Let's see, we hard coded Java home here, but we don't want to hard code Hadoop home. That is again simple, nothing very big to be done. I'll not hard code Hadoop home here, but in place of that, I'll mention Hadoop home environment variable in my environment variables. So you'll have the idea of both the ways that it can be done. Same way we can do for Java also. I'll go here. You know, this is my Hadoop directory. I'll cancel. I'll make a new system variable. The path will be, make sure the all the homes that we are defining, that does not include bin. So the path will be this, and the name that we are expecting is Hadoop home. So I'll mention the Hadoop home. Let's click OK. You can see here now Hadoop home is also defined. So nothing big here. This command will take Hadoop home from our environment variables. It could have taken Java home also, but anyways, we can define it like this also. Let's save this. Now guys, there is one last step that is only required when you are doing Hadoop installation on Windows. Actually, for running Hadoop, it requires some specific Windows related binary files, that is in bin directory. But by default, this package that we downloaded from Hadoop official website, that does not have all the files here that should be there if this binary has to run on Windows. For this particular case, there is a package available for different version of Hadoop. We call it winutils. So winutils is nothing but another bin folder that if we are using Hadoop on Windows, we can extract that winutils, we'll get a bin folder, and we'll directly remove the default bin folder and replace that winutils bin folder in this directory. As simple as that. There is nothing big in that. So for winutils, whatever version you are using, you can search on Google winutils for that Hadoop version. Anyways, I'll provide the link of latest winutils in the description. When you open the link, it will be something like this: binaries and winutils for Hadoop 3.1.1. It does not have anything else but a bin directory. You can download it as a zip. You'll get something like this: Apache Hadoop 3.1.1 winutils master. Okay, let me extract this. Here, if you open this, you can see we have a bin directory. And inside this bin directory, you can see we have way more files than we have it in fresh copy that we just downloaded. I'll just copy it. I'll go back to my Hadoop directory. This is the bin. For a safer side, let me not remove it. I'll rename it as a backup. And let's paste that directory here. That's all. You can see in the older one, we have limited number of files, and here we have another files that are useful for running Hadoop on Windows. So our setup is done. Now just to test what we can do, we can open our CMD and check the Hadoop version. So it's giving us 3.1.3. So we can say as of now, the Hadoop home directory is correctly picking up and we are able to get the Hadoop version. Now it's our first run. Let's first of all format the name node. The command will be hdfs name node hyphen format. This does nothing, but this is just a first installation and we have created new directories for name node and data node. So after a fresh install, it's better to format your name node. Don't do it if you have data on your HDFS. So you'll get output something like this. Now let us try to start our Hadoop daemons. For doing that, you have to go to our Hadoop directory. Inside this, you have to go to sbin directory instead of bin directory. Here you can see start dfs and start yarn commands. These are the two commands. This will start your Hadoop daemon. This will start your yarn daemon. So either you can double click here or you can do cmd. Let me increase the font. Start dfs hyphen cmd. You can see a couple of windows popping up. These are different daemons getting started. We'll check after this. You can minimize this. And now you can do start yarn.cmd. So whatever windows popping up you can see, you can minimize it and close it. Don't close whatever processes are running. Otherwise, all the daemons will go down. To validate, let's go to our browser and check localhost 8088, which is the default port of yarn. So you can see here, yarn UI is up and running. Similarly, we can check the name node port. The name node port would be 9870. In older version, it was 50070, and after Hadoop 3, it is 9870. You can check the respective ports for the name nodes and the yarn UI for your latest version. These are easily available on official documentations. So this is the name node. You can see here the number of data nodes. There is only one data node running, that is my laptop itself. Also try other HDFS commands. Suppose I want to create some directory inside HDFS. So I'll type HDFS DFS hyphen mkdir. In root, I will make a directory arpit. So let's see if it is created. Inside utilities, let's go to browse file system. You can see inside root, there is one directory arpit. So this way, now your single node Hadoop cluster is all ready. Actually guys, my purpose of making this video, first to tell you how to install a Hadoop cluster on any Windows machine from scratch. And second, I want to build entire Hadoop infrastructure, keep one version of it on Windows itself, which is very quick and handy instead of firing up Cloudera Quick Start VM and heavy virtual machines. And onto this Hadoop, in my next video, I'll install Spark, which I will run on yarn. I'll integrate this Hadoop with Hive and basically all the useful tools and resources that we get in Cloudera Quick Start VM. And if you follow these steps along with me, you can use all these utilities in your native Windows environment, even if you don't have a heavy resource laptop, those run those heavy virtual machines smoothly. So keep watching GK Code Labs. In my next video in this series, I'm going to install Hive, HBase, Spark, which I'll run on this same Hadoop using yarn and Kafka. And we'll try to use same environment for our future Spark related videos. So thank you guys for watching this video. Hope you liked it. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. See you in my next video. Keep watching.